When was the aha moment in your human journey, your origin story, when you knew this was your pathway? You know, this is it's a fairly unique, you know, to do it professionally. I mean, and I would argue that most people, that's probably one of their greatest fears is public speaking, which is a whole nother discussion.
Yes. So I was a conference event planner early in my career, one of my first jobs out of college, and I was hiring these professional speakers for thousands of dollars that would do a one-man show up on the stage. I was just blown away. Like, we paid them how much money? And they flew here and told their story and just performed beautifully.
Yeah.
So that really planted the seed. I was in my early 20s, and I remember thinking, I have no message and no credibility, but someday, I could do that. I could get up on that stage and do that. And of course, growing up in the family band and having been a professional singer since age 7, I had the stage presence and I didn't get butterflies like so many people do. And so I had planted that seed in my 20s of figuring out a niche, something that people would want to listen to me about. And so, of course, when I started my business and everyone was complaining about millennials and turnover and, you know, workforce stuff, I found my expertise and I thought, okay, I am one of these young workers that they're complaining about and I get it. So that's really what planted the seed and what gave me the inspiration to become a professional speaker and trainer.
I'm going to love your answer to this next question. Okay. What is it like to be Cara Silletto?
A lot of smiling. I have a deep-rooted optimism, and I'm sure that comes mostly from my mom. I think part of it's genes, honestly, that my son, I can already tell, he's just a happy kid. And he looked outside yesterday, just looked out the window and said, "Mom, it's amazing outside." And I saw the reflection of myself in that comment, that I just look for the special things in life. I have the Anne Frank complex. I think everyone is good on the inside, and that I find the positive in most situations. My dad taught me to look at the rainbows and not just look at them, but appreciate it. Because you can't recreate a rainbow in the sky whenever you want. You can't do that. So you have to catch it while it's there. And he really made me realize that you don't want to bypass those amazing times. So really, it's just a lot of happiness and finding joy in things and surrounding myself with people. I am a true 99% extrovert on the on the spectrum of that, which means I just feed off of other people and get my energy from other people. So while my husband is in sales and he has to be social at work, you know, and sell and talk and chit chat, he comes home to recharge by himself. And I am the opposite, where I need to recharge by talking to people and being around people. And so that's absolutely what's going on in my head.